I can't believe that another academic year has come and gone. 2020 has felt like we've lived through all 365 days and we're only in September. We come together again this fall to renew our commitment to those in our communities, to be fair, to be transparent, to provide opportunities, and to be inclusive. To give thanks to you, the school counselors, educators, advisors, community-based organizations, and administrators, whose mission it is to connect people to a post-secondary education, no matter what that looks like, where it is, or when they decide to take that next step. You are selfless, you are passionate, and above all else, you are filled with optimism and hope. We too are filled with hope. Hope, knowledge, and opportunity, the motto of FIU. So let me start by giving you some pre-pandemic highlights from 2019. Then we'll take a look at how we've been making it through this last 6 months. And I'll finish by sharing with you where we're going to go from here for the class of 2021. First, I never talk much about rankings, but FIU received a number of accolades from the Times Higher Education Impact Rankings, and these captured the real essence of the university: our care for the community and environment, our empathetic approach to all living things, and our service to others. Times Higher Education gives global rankings, and FIU is ranked in the top 50 in the world for life below water, no poverty, and as a peace, justice, and strong institution. Life Below Water is a ranking that measures a university's research on the life below water and their education on or support for aquatic ecosystems. From ridge to reef, FIU students and researchers are addressing the most urgent challenges in our environment. No Poverty, which measures a university's research on poverty and measures a university's support for low-income students and citizens in their local community. We believe that we have a responsibility to our community, and we take that responsibility very seriously. And as a peace, justice, and strong institution, which measures a university's research on law and international relations, their participation as advisors for government, and their policies on academic freedom. FIU students, faculty, and staff are involved in social innovation, social entrepreneurship, and change making through leadership, research, philanthropy, community service, and civic engagement. We are also recognized as an Ashoka Changemaker campus. There's only so much you can learn in a lab or in a lecture hall, so we seek out answers where no one is looking. For students in the Chaplin School of Hospitality and Tourism Management, that meant the opportunity to take the David Grootman experience. Who is David Grootman, you might ask, especially if you're not from Miami? Grootman is the managing partner of two of Miami's hottest nightclubs, as well as a number of restaurants. He's known as the king of Miami nightlife. This class covered concept development, marketing and PR, finance and human resources, and he had guest lecturers like Pharrell Williams and DJ Khaled. It's no wonder the Chaplin School of Hospitality and Tourism Management always receives top rankings around the world. Speaking of global rankings and world domination, FIU students soared to the top of the charts as the Model UN team took home the win and became the champions of North America. These masters of diplomacy also won Best Large Delegation at the Harvard University National Model UN. This was another first for FIU. It makes a lot of sense for the Model UN to be on top. Students of the FIU Green School of International and Public Affairs receive a well-rounded education in diplomacy, public policy, human rights, and culture. There's even a diplomat in residence and an FIU office in DC for government relations and internships. As October turned to November, we did something that no one ever thought we'd do. We turned the Miami Marlins baseball park into a football stadium. And then the FIU Panthers football team beat the University of Miami Hurricanes 24-30. It was the football game that shocked the nation. The win was so epic that even Meet the Press's Chuck Todd was left speechless. Spring arrived. As quickly as it started, the world then changed. and FIU President Mark Rosenberg asked that all faculty and staff do 5 things. Keep calm, be creative, work with intentionality, have clarity, and above all else, be flexible. Our FIU moved more than 4,000 courses from face-to-face to remote within a matter of days. We gave out hundreds of laptops and hotspots to connect FIU students to faculty, staff, and each other. We didn't shut down because we know that we have a responsibility, not just to educate, but to care for those who trust us with their future. We housed students who couldn't go home for a variety of reasons. We fed those who needed a meal. We provided over $19 million in emergency aid. We hosted 2 meaningful graduation ceremonies for those who worked so hard and triumphed over adversity. In admissions, we didn't just move a deadline. We sent an email to every admitted student and said, "We're here. What can we do to help you in your specific situation?" We offered orientation, counseling, recreation activities, and student engagement through videos and live streaming to keep students involved and healthy, physically, emotionally, and academically. We have doubled down on our efforts in serving our community and doing research. Students at the Robotics and Digital Fabrication Lab have been producing PPE for hospitals and critical parts for ventilators. Our faculty experts in infectious diseases, public health, business, and the hospitality industry have been working overtime to conduct research and share valuable information around the world. We have kept up with progress on campus too. We broke ground on 2 new buildings. The first is a second building for the School of International and Public Affairs. And the second, a new residence hall dedicated to continuing students. We have new majors as well: environmental chemistry, forensic chemistry, and behavioral neuroscience, and majors in growth markets such as logistics and supply chain management, business analytics, sustainability and the environment, and digital communications and management. And it may seem small, but FIU has been thinking big, and not just about traditional learning. The FIU Micro-Credentialing Initiative has been launched to prepare all learners with 21st century critical competencies. And as we welcome the class of 2020, we also turn our attention to the class of 2021. We know their college search and selection experience will be like no other. We have also once again altered the pathways. At least this year, there's only 6 of them. One pathway to pay particular attention to is the FIU Top 10% pathway. If a high school student is graduating from a Florida high school in the top 10% of their class, we will admit them. While the scores are needed and placement is important, especially in STEM majors and in business, we will provide an admissions pathway to students who are excelling in the classroom regardless as to what their score is on a standardized test. We are giving more weight to the GPA, the curriculum, and the sequence of courses in the admissions decision-making process. But that also comes with the understanding that preparation in the classroom is extremely important, and that excelling academically in core courses will play a greater role in our admissions decisions. It's not just about getting in, it's about the outcomes and what happens when you graduate. We have an intense focus on this from the point of application through the life cycle of the learner. All pathways have the same mission: to get you through FIU, not to just get you in to FIU. Connect for Success, Golden Scholars, STEP, Starting in Early Fall and Not Fall. These are all research-based decisions to match an applicant's academic record with the best pathway through FIU in the major they selected when they applied. The FIU Golden Promise is in its 4th year. This is our commitment to incoming first-time in college Florida residents with an EFC equal to 0 that FIU will meet 100% of tuition and fees for all 4 years. This is done through grants and scholarships, not loans. Most importantly for the class of 2021, we have moved our scholarship priority deadline from November 1st to January 15th. We know that taking an SAT or ACT has been a challenge, and we remain committed to flexibility. We have also continued our work with the Raise Me Micro Scholarships. From our humble beginnings on the land of the old Tamiami Airport, we have continued to push forward, to work with a sense of purpose and urgency, and to make a real lasting impact. I leave you with gratitude. Thank you for all you do, for your advice, your encouragement, and your kind words. Thank you for being the light for so many. This has been a year like no other, and we have all truly been tested as leaders, educators, and human beings. Please continue to reach out when we can be of service, and above all else, go Panthers.